Let us just have a quick review on the gross anatomical features of the kidneys.
Now what we see here are specimens of the kidney. So when you are given a specimen in the exam, you lift it up, look at the hilum and first identify the three structures. Anterior most is the renal vein, then is the renal artery, and posterior most should be the ureter, which is pointing downwards. So that helps us in identifying that this kidney belongs to the right side. This is the upper pole, the lower pole, the anterolateral surface, the posteromedial surface, the medial border, which shows the hilum, and the lateral convex border. Now how does it lie in the body? You hold it this way so that the upper pole is nearer to the midline than the lower pole, and the surfaces should be as anterolateral and posteromedial surface. So this is how it lies in the body. Relations of the right kidney: it is related to the suprarenal gland, the liver, the sea of the duodenum, the hepatic flexure of colon, and the jejunum. Posteriorly, it is related above to the diaphragm, then to the medial and the lateral arcuate ligaments. Lower part is related to the psoas major muscle, the quadratus lumborum muscle, and the transversus abdominis, and also to the subcostal vessels and the subcostal nerve, the iliohypogastric and the ilioinguinal nerve. Whereas when we look at the other kidney, again similarly looking at the hilum, identify the renal vein, the renal artery, and the ureter, which is posterior most and going downwards. That helps us in identifying that this kidney belongs to the left side, upper pole, lower pole, the anterolateral surface, the posteromedial surface, medial border, and the lateral border. And this is how it lies in the body. Relations of the left kidney: anterior surface, it is related to the suprarenal gland, to the spleen, the stomach, the splenic artery, pancreas, splenic flexure of colon, and the coils of jejunum and ileum. Posterior relations will be same: upper part related to the diaphragm, then the medial and the lateral arcuate ligaments, the psoas major muscle, the quadratus lumborum muscle, and the transversus abdominis, along with the subcostal nerve and vessels, iliohypogastric nerve and ilioinguinal nerve. So these were features that you should know identifying, holding a normal anatomical position, and talking of the relations of both the surfaces of the right and the left kidney. Thank you.